Okay, we're doing chapter 8, and yes, I do be happy because I'm just so happy that we have knowledge of self and we also have solutions. Okay, so chapter 8, how your ancestral helpers can protect you against robbery, theft, muggings, rape, vandalism, even death. That's what's up. If we don't need that, I don't know who do. This is page 113. The history of man has been the history of war, criminal and selfish behavior of large numbers, willful destruction, rape, and murder. That man has survived it all in a miracle in itself, especially us. It indicates that the inner self or a few was at work keeping man from destroying himself and all forms of earth life. Total destruction would have otherwise been inevitable. We are particularly conscious of all of these problems right now, as is what the book says. Will we survive the year 2000 AD? It seems to even be unsafe to go out at night or even in the daytime in some locations. Man has to literally go into his home and board it up for the night. This situation of murder over 800 in Detroit in 1974, fraudulent and criminal behavior, arson, etc., will continue unabated until a large enough group of people start releasing astral power and using this formula. A new type of guidance is needed. I'm offering you a new type of guidance that very few humans have accepted in the past. As we enter the age of Aquarius, in which spiritual development will come into its own, there is hope that a greater astral power will change human behavior for the better. We hear ministers talk about the power of prayer. This is their solution. Prayer never stopped the Second World War or any war in the history of man. Prayer never stopped the criminal from committing a crime. In the introduction to my book, I told you about the great civilization of the Olmecs in Central America, which was over 10,000 years ago. They tapped into astral powers. Our ancestors tapped into astral power to provide all the good things in their lives. But they never developed an astral projection plan. So eventually, they were destroyed by the Spanish hoarders who killed them off and stole or destroyed all our earthly possessions.
So we as a people need to develop an astral protection plan. All right, that's the key. All right. Right now, you don't call on our ancestors. You don't ask for help, you know, as a mass, as the masses of the so-called Moors, i.e. black people, African-Americans. You don't call on our ancestors. So therefore, we lack protection. And this is one of the ways in which I can help with that.
They never developed an astral projection plane.
Projection or protection.
So eventually they were destroyed by the Spaniard hoarders who killed them off and destroyed all of their earthly possessions. The Spaniards brought friars, which were religious men, with them. These so-called religious men could not understand the Olmecian and the Mayan superior way of life. They actually believed that the Mayans were uncivilized and the Olmecs were savages. Even Christ paid with his physical life because the people of his time didn't understand his mission and would not change their pure physical but largely negative ways of living and thinking. For many years, I have often wondered how any man could take the life of another being. It would not take much for me to be a vegetarian since I respect all forms of life. I really don't stir emotions when you read of people being forced to give up their physical lives for a couple of dollars or a few cents. I never could understand how any man could rape a beautiful woman and then kill the one who gave him physical pleasure. My questions are many, and I still do not have the answers. However, I do know that you can protect yourself and protect your loved ones through full application of this magical formula.
All right.
An example, David found the way. His friends were always warning David about the areas he passed through at night to his home from work. There were muggings and rapes and even murder in this area. David wasn't afraid. No one ever bothered him. If they ever did attempt any criminal act, the flash of white astral light would scare the heck out of them.
Now, check this out. As my wife and I was riding, we was in the neighborhood where the cops often patrol, I should say. This one officer pulled up on us, and we had Harriet Tubman in the back and Anubis on top of the car. That's what we visualized. And we visualized Psalms 121, 122 for safe travel. Whatever this officer seen, it might have been this white light, but he sped off real fast, and shoot, we sped off right behind him, catching him at the light.
What just happened? So, because I was navigating, went on up there, and then we pulled up to the light, he was there, and he was like this. And I was like, Eileen, what just happened? Because we had just got together that time.
Right.
And he was like, oh, I was picturing Anubis on the top of the car. And I was like, oh. So
and Harriet Tubman in the back.
So no one ever bothered David. If they ever did attempt any criminal act, the flash of white astral light would scare the heck out of them. David's astral helpers were on the job. Recently, I answered the door to find a man with a piece of paper in his hand. He wanted to talk to me about something. As he started to enter our apartment, a startled look came over his face and he turned and ran out of the building. My astral helpers read his mind. They knew that he was up to no good. The answers to crime, war, and all negative behavior are not found in the physical. Our trouble is that we measure everything by our physical senses. We insist on better police and fire protection. We sign treaties with other nations thinking that they will bring peace. We spend billions getting ready for war and kid ourselves into thinking that this is the way to bring peace. We tell a woman not to go out alone at night, but provide her with a weapon. Millions of handguns and rifles are being sold. For important people, we provide bodyguards and secret service of men who follow their charges around night and day. What a way to live. We pass thousands of laws for the purpose of controlling physical behavior. We control man's driving, navigations, and tell him where he can and cannot go. We even tell him what shows and other forms of entertainment he can see or can feel. We also tell him who he can or cannot marry. Yet with all these physical controls, crime and illegal behavior are all around. The answer must come from the inner self. We will never find the answers to problems of any kind in the purely physical realms. The answer must come from the God within you, your inner self. It is through my formula, meditation, concentration and contemplation that you become aware of the astral power and the astral helpers who can give you the answers to your problems. Astral power make it possible for you to cope with anything you may be called upon to face on this planet Earth. However, it is up to you in every phase of your life to make use of this great force and of your astral helpers. The force and the helpers are there. They have always been there. But billions of people have never found them. It is up to you to tap into this wondrous power. God never stopped war and never will. If each person found peace as a result of releasing his inner self, there would be no war. If every person made full use of their astral helpers, there would be no crime or poverty or sickness. Alice and Fred walked away from a highway accident. And we all have family and friends who've done this. When Alice and Fred walked away from a tragic highway accident caused by the morning fog and a pileup of cars, it was unbelievable to many of their friends and also to many of their family members. Several were killed and many were injured. All available ambulances from several nearby towns were called to carry the injured to the hospitals. The car in which Alice and Fred were riding was particularly distraught. Their secret, my astral power protection plan. That's what you were just talking about, baby. A protection plan. Ira did not believe me. Ira did not believe that there could be a protection plan from the astral world. He looked at me like he thought I was touched in the head. A kook. However, he was willing to give it a try. He told me later that he thought he would be able to prove me wrong. I told him that he would need to be 100% for the plan or it wouldn't work. Over a period of 30 years, he left his car unlocked. Days. Oh, yeah. Thank you, baby. He walked through dangerous areas with over $100 on him. He gave thugs all the chance in the world to perform some illegal acts. He even dropped his pocketbook on a main street with $50 and 9 credit cards in it. The pocketbook was returned. Nothing was missing. He could do nothing else but admit that I was right. Wow. That's deep because that's how it is in I left my purse underneath the table. It had $300 in it. And 2 days later, at a different location, nothing was taken out. Rose finds the answer. Rose finds the answer. Her friends were always asking Rose why she wasn't raped or why she wasn't robbed. She would even leave her apartment door unlocked. She always left the keys in her car and nothing happened. Rose didn't bother to explain my plan. She simply showed the question, a lucky charm that she bought in the novelty store, of course. The real reason was my astral protection plan. It is up to you. More policemen, more firemen, more laws, more government, more interference with your life. Larger prisons, capital punishment, more organization for the rehabilitation of the criminal. Stiffer fines, etc., 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 are definitely not the answer. For millions of years, man has tried to find a physical answer to earthly problems. He still depends upon his physical senses. He never seems to learn. He tries to stop war by stockpiling war materials and building huge armies, navies, and air forces. If a man destroys your home and kills your wife and children, the court, after spending thousands of dollars in many weeks, sends him to jail if they can find him. God will let anyone persecute you, push you around, steal from you, destroy your property, put you in a hospital, and even kill you for no reason at all? It happens millions of times every day. But don't blame God. He had a plan that you never followed in the past. All the crime and destruction in the world is unnecessary and useless. It is up to you to protect yourself from all the wickedness of the planet Earth. Wow. What is not the answer? Wearing seatbelts, having your car equipped with airbags, carrying a gun so that you can kill the other fellow before he kills you, teaching a girl karate to save her from rape, staying home every night because of fear, producing extra locks, hiring bodyguards, depending upon prayer that would not reach above the housetops, going into church, etc., and not the answers. They never have been and they never will be. The real answer is to release spiritual forces and not physical forces. Fine-tuning of the magic formula. It is especially important that you do some fine-tuning of your formula for best results. However, before I tell you how to tune in astral protection, I should like to discuss two events that I read about in the morning paper. You have no trouble finding cases like the ones I'm about to relate to you. The daily papers are filled with criminal happenings out of the many reports that day. There was the one of the police switchboard operators hearing two people being murdered, but naturally she could do nothing about it. It appears that a husband and wife have been Christmas shopping. After they returned home and entered their house, they became aware that a robbery was in process. Undoubtedly, the first thought that came to their minds was to call the police. However, it never occurred to them to walk softly out of the house and over to a neighbor's to make the call. The three robbers heard the wife making the phone call and shot the pair dead just as the police station answered the phone. When the police arrived, they found that the house had been ramshacked from top to bottom. The couple were dead beside the phone. Now, if the couple had been protected by the astral protection plan, there would have been no robbers in their house. there would have been no need to call the police, and the couple would have enjoyed Christmas and many years to come. To date, the police have no idea who committed this atrocity. Even if the police did apprehend the killers, what good would it do? Sending the robbers and prisoners to prison wouldn't bring this couple back. And the second case concerns the family of top General Motors executives. They had a party the night before this tragic event. About 1:30 the following morning, the whole $125,000 house was in flames. The executive's wife threw herself through the living room window and rushed next door to call the fire department. She is now in critical condition in the hospital with first-degree burns all over her body and many cuts due to her flying through the glass. The charred bodies of the father and his two children were found at the front door of their beautiful home. Why didn't they all escape? They could not get the front door open because, conscious of several robberies in this exclusive suburb of Detroit, Mr. Executive had extra locks on the doors, and the locks didn't show from the outside. The inside locks needed a key to open the door. My executive thought was protecting his family by purely physical means. All I have already told you, this is practically no protection at all. When found by the firemen, the father had the key to the extra lock in his hand but could not use it fast enough to save himself and his children. The end result of the depending upon physical means of protection were 3 deaths and 1 critically injured. By the way, the fire started from a cigarette butt that smoldered for several hours on the living room floor couch under a pillow. If this executive had used my formula, he would not have needed extra locks that resulted in 3 deaths and total destruction of the house. One of his astral helpers, if he had sense enough to use one, would have told him to check the couch before retiring for the night. In addition to all of this, think of the emotional turmoil this executive's wife will be under if she lives. I surely would not want to carry this burden. Every unfortunate situation that I read or hear about could have been avoided by the full use of this formula. I have called your attention to the facts that it is up to you to find the answer for your problems. It is up to you to release this powerful force. This will get you somewhere. God never imposes on your free will. Actually, while you're going through the motions of shifting your problems onto everyone else, you could find the answer to your problems yourself. Don't expect God or your friends or your government to make you rich, healthy, or wise. Depend upon your own released inner self. Astral helpers and cosmic consciousness, if you need $2,000 of fire protection and protection from all evil forces of the world, develop the appropriate mental action images. See yourself with money. See yourself enjoying your home and your environment without destruction of any kind. Women, sisters, goddesses should see themselves going about their daily activity without being raped, beaten up, or molested in any way. Put the actual blueprint into your subconscious mind during your meditation. Reduce your awareness of all consciousness to the lowest point possible. Under no condition should you give any indication of how this solution has come about. By all means, give your astral helpers and your creative consciousness the full opportunity to find the answers. Why should you care how the solution comes about? You shouldn't care. After you have found the correct mental actions, images, and made them very vivid to your mind, forget about them. Use your astral helpers. They'll find the solution, and your mental action images will become reality. If you do not picture what you want in a full meditation situation, you'll never get it. To picture safety, prosperity, happiness, and health results in your inner self realizing the astral powers and the astral helpers. Your blueprints of the life situations that you desire become reality in this way. The reason that you should not think about all these blueprints during your conscious life is that fears and that doubts and that other negative emotions will creep in and will cancel them out. Getting your conscious mind mixed up into your meditation and your mental action images can even result in getting just the opposite of what you want. when you meditate, you set the stage. Afterwards, you forget it, and you let your astral helpers find the answers to your problems, or you point the way to the complete satisfaction of your desires. This is called fine-tuning. Fine-tuning is especially necessary for protection from all evil forces because it's difficult to keep fears, doubt, nervousness, tension, and all negative emotions out of your mind. Set the stage and then wait for the results. This will exceed your greatest expectations. Affirmations designed to protect you. Generally, every day at the regular meditation period, I wish to thank all of my ancestral friends again for protecting our homes and for protecting ourselves.
This is the mantra that you will repeat. So we'll read this again.
I know that God's pure white light will always be on guard, no matter where we are. Generally, every day at your regular meditation period, I wish to thank all of my ancestral friends again for protecting our home and ourselves.
I wish to thank all of my astral friends again for protecting our home and ourselves.
I know that God's pure white light will always be on guard no matter where we are.
I know that God's pure white light will always be on guard no matter where we are.
Thanks to my astral helpers, there's a tight band of security always around my car and other possessions.
Thanks to my astral helpers, there is always a tight band of security always around my car and other possessions.
My home and my loved ones.
My homes and my loved ones.
I know that it will always be there.
I know it will always be there.
Special situations.
So for trips or vacation, you could say this one.
As we start our vacation and business trip.
As we start our vacation or business trip.
We again ask our dear spirit friends to protect us.
We ask again our dear spirit friends to protect us.
At all times and provide a safe journey.
And at all times and provide a safe journey.
To and from our destination.
To and from our destination.
We are eventually grateful for this protection.
We are eternally grateful for this protection.
For the girl who wants to avoid being molested, you say, I am placing my complete faith and trust in my astral helpers.
Well, this is even for
a boy
who doesn't want to be molested. Who don't want to get mugged or molested either. Right. I'm placing my complete faith and trust in my astral helpers.
With the aid of God's powerful astral force.
With the aid of God's powerful astral force.
I will be safe no matter where I am.
I will be safe no matter where I am.
Walking, riding, or seeking the comfort of my home.
Walking, riding, or seeking the comfort of my home.
Of course, the necessary mental action images must go with this affirmation. It is well to repeat them quite often. It is necessary to repeat those for special trips or situations. These affirmations are suggestions. You can write your own if you wish. And if you do them, then please continue to, because it makes them more and more powerful the more you use them. You can develop specific affirmations for specific situations, as you already know. How well do I remember two occasions when my astral helpers saved my life? I was driving my car along a street near our home when another car came down the street at high speed. I was not aware of this car until I saw it shoot in front of my car and hit a tree. The young man driving this car was thrown out of the car and as it hit the tree, coming to a stop standing on end. This young fellow suffered only a bloody nose. All that he could think of was that his mother would say when she saw the car. I would have been killed instantly. If it had not been my astral helpers. On another occasion, I had tickets for an afternoon flight to the West Coast. My ancestral helpers suggested there were things that I needed to do at home and to postpone my trip into the evening flight. I have long since learned never to question the suggestions or methods of solving a problem that comes from my ancestral helpers. I postponed the trip. The afternoon flight ended disastrously. The plane exploded over the mountains. And there was no survivors. I am certain that you read about the 193 Muslims who were making a religious pilgrimage to Mecca. The plane crashed, killing all 193 on board. They did not reach Mecca. They undoubtedly woke up in the astral world. He says, please don't take this chapter lightly. I've been thinking the whole time how intense it was. Follow my formula will protect you from all of the evil, criminal, and destructive forces on this earthly plane.
Right. So go back and develop these mantras that we just went over. You can write your own or use the ones in which that is in the book that we stated. But this will help you greatly.
Wow.
We promise.
Peace and love. And real quick, I wanted to read.
Go through our normal one.
Yep. On page 29. So remember, picture images as well as words. Continuing now and for days and years to come.
Continuing now for days and years to come.
I am moving towards my most cherished goals.
I am moving towards my most cherished goals.
My life is becoming rich with happiness.
My life is becoming rich with happiness.
A better economic condition and full contentment.
A better economic condition and full contentment.
Every action, enterprise, or endeavor in which I wish to be involved.
Every action, enterprise, or endeavor in which I wish to be involved
is bringing increased reward.
Is bringing increasing rewards.
Life is making its joys and happiness easier to come by.
Life is making its joys and happiness easier to come by.
Good fortune is coming my way more and more frequently.
Good fortunes are coming my way more and more frequently.
I'm learning how to share my good fortune by helping others along the way.
I'm learning how to share my good fortunes with others along the way.
I am truly moving closer to a oneness with God.
I'm truly moving closer to the oneness of God.
And the full release of my inner
self.